So students, in the last class yesterday, we were discussing about the electronic configuration of elements from atomic number 1 to 10. Now we move to elements with atomic number 11 to 20 and 21 to 30. Okay, so element with atomic number 11, that is sodium. Element with atomic number 12, magnesium. Element with atomic number 13, that is aluminium. Element with atomic number 14, that is silicon. Next, phosphorus. Next, sulfur. Next, chlorine. Next, argon. Next, potassium. Next, calcium. So we shall discuss about the electronic configuration of these elements. Okay, today I'll show the other way also. Yesterday also I have shown you how to write the electronic configuration in two ways. Okay, so here sodium is 11, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. I told you the order of the orbitals, how the energy of the orbitals goes on increasing. In that way you have to fill up the orbitals. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. After 2p it is 3s. So it is 3s1. Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, which is 3s2. Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. Next, 3p. So 3p1. Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2. Okay? Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. Okay? Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. I told the capacity of p orbitals is 6 electrons. So 3s2, 3p4. See here, how the other way I... You can represent the electronic configuration. I'll show you. 1s. This is 1s orbital containing 2 electrons. Next, 2s. One will spin clockwise. One electron will spin clockwise. The other will spin anticlockwise. Next, 2p6. There are 3p orbitals. So, next, 3s. Next, 3p. 1, 2, 3 and 4. I told you that is according to Mohs. Okay. So here, next, you have for chlorine. Okay. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. After 3p it is 4s. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. Okay, so here this is electronic configuration of elements up to atomic number 20. So, just like I have shown you the other way of electronic configuration, you can do it for the other elements also. Okay? So, here. Now, look here. 1s2. 2s2. 2p6. This is the electronic configuration of a noble gas. Which noble gas? Which noble gas? It is neon. So, here you can write. The other way you can write here is neon 3s1. You can write the electronic configuration in terms of noble gases also. Okay, so here again 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 is electronic configuration of noble gas. Neon. So neon 3s2. Again, neon 3s2, 3p1. You can write like this also. Okay, in terms of noble gases. For magnesium, you can write 3s2. You can write like this. Okay, this is also the other way of writing the electronic configuration. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Next, we go for elements from atomic number 21 to 30. Now, here I can can give you a code. Elements atomic number 21 to 30. You usually know up to atomic number 20. Okay. Now, for elements from atomic number 21 to 30. Scandium. Sky. T. V. Sky, T, V. Chromium. Scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium. Next is manganese. Next, iron. Sky, T, V. Chromium. Fe, iron. Co. When you are writing cobalt, C should be capital, O should be small. 27. Co-ni. 28. Fe-co-ni. Cousin. Not Susan, it is cousin. So 29. 30. So here you write the atomic number of the element on the left hand side. Okay. At the lower left hand side. Okay. So here, sky, TV, chromium, fe-co-ni, cousin. That is the code for remembering these elements. Others you can remember easily. Okay. So here, scandium. Scandium comes after calcium. Okay. So instead of writing all the entire configuration, you can write argon. You can write it as argon 4s1. Okay, so here element with atomic number, you can write it like this: 3d1, 4s2. 4s is filled, electron next will go to 3d orbital. But when you are writing it, you will write it in this order because 3 comes before 4. That is why you will write like this: 3D1, 4S2. Okay. Next, again, argon. 3D2, 4S2. 4S is filled up, its capacity is over. Electron will go to the next d orbital. What is the capacity of d orbital? It is 10 electrons because there are 5 d orbitals. Okay, one orbital containing 2 electrons. So next, argon. It will be 3D3, 4S2. This will remain as it is. The electrons will go on getting added to the 3D orbital. Next. Now look here. You cannot write 3D4, 4S2. That should have been the electronic configuration of chromium. Chromium, the electronic configuration, you will be added to 3D4, 4S2. Adre yen aithe nodu. 3D5, 4S1. 3D5, 4S1. Why it is like this and why it is not 3D4, 4S2? Because, look here. How many d orbitals are there? 5 d orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right. Now here. This is 3D5 electronic configuration, right? So here, in 3D5 electronic configuration, if you see, each orbital is containing one electron. So we say that the electronic configuration is symmetrical, symmetry, equal distribution is there of the electrons in the orbital. That is why the electronic configuration is more stable. How that we symmetry just say, either d orbital. 5 d orbital one electron aithe andre equal distribution agi electron illi adukka electronic configuration 3d4 4s2 illa yen aithe 3d5 4s1 arthata this is because of half filled d orbital antena half filled aithe adr jothe innond electron illa pairing agilla illi so there are half filled d orbitals. Okay, if the orbital contains only one electron we call it as half filled. If it contains two electrons, it is completely filled orbital. Okay. So your next it will be argon. 3D5, 4S2. Here it should have been 4S2, right? But it is 3D5, 4S1. So next one, 3D5, 4S2. Remaining will be same. Next, argon. 3D6, 4S2. Next, argon. 3D7, 4S2. Next, argon. 3D8, 4s2. Next, argon. Now here, what should have been the electronic configuration? 3d9 4s2, but it is not 3d9 4s2. It is 3d10 4s1. Look here. What it should have been? 3d9 4s2. It is not like this. How it is? 3d10 4s1. Again, how many d orbitals are there? There are 5 d orbitals. Now each orbital is containing 2 electrons. Again, there is symmetrical distribution of the electrons. Each orbital is containing 2 electrons. The distribution of electrons is symmetrical. That is why the electronic configuration, which electronic configuration? 3d10 4s1 is more stable. Which is more stable, that will take place. So, since this electronic configuration is more stable, the electronic configuration of copper is 3d10 4s1 and not 3d9 4s2. I hope this is clear. Okay. Next, argon. 3d10 4s2. Okay. So, I hope this electronic configuration is clear to you. Argon, I told you, you can write the electronic configuration in terms of noble gases. ನೋಡ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಬಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಏನದಾವಲ್ಲ ಬಹಳ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಅದಾವ. ಸೊ ಅದ್ರ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ನಾಗ ನಾವು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಬರೀಬಹುದು. ಆರ್ಗಾನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್, ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾ? ಆರ್ಗಾನ್ 18, ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ನಂಬರ್ 18 ಇದೆ. ಸೊ 18 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ. 18 19 20 21. ತಿಳಿತು? ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಈಸಿ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಹ್ಯಾಂಗ್ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು. ಈಗ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ನಂಬರ್ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, 21. ಸೊ 1 3d1 4s2. Atomic number 22, 3d2, 4s2. Next, 23, 3d3, 4s2. 24, 3d5. This is exception. This is exception. 3d5, 4s1. Next, you go 25, 3d5, 4s2. You see this number. This goes to 4s. This goes to 3d. Right? Again, 3d6, 4s2. 3d7, 4s2. 3d8, 4s2. This is exception. 3d9 4s2 ಇರಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು, ಆದ್ರೆ ಏನೈತಿ? 3d10 4s1. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ 3d10 4s2. ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಟು ಯು. ಓಕೆ. ನೌ ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೌ, ವೆನ್ ದ ಡಿ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್, not only d orbitals, even p orbitals. How many p orbitals are there? 3 p orbitals are there. Px, py and pz. If they are half filled, this is known as half filled, containing one, each orbital is containing one electron. This is completely filled. This is half filled. So, Px, Py and Pz. So, when the p orbitals are completely filled or half filled, the electronic configuration is more stable. The electronic configuration is more stable because of symmetry. Because of symmetry. ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತೈತಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಇವೆಂಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ಅದನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಆಗ್ತಿರ್ತೈತಿ. ನಾವು ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ, ದ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್. Right. So, when the orbitals are either half filled or completely filled, then the electronic configuration is stable. This is with p orbitals as well as d orbitals as well as f orbitals also. So, how many d orbitals are there? 5 d orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Right. So, dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square minus y square and dz square. So, if they are half filled, if the d orbitals they are half filled or they are completely filled, then the electronic configuration is very stable because of symmetry. Because of symmetry. Symmetry means equal distribution of electrons, you can see. Right? So that is about the electronic configuration. Okay. Now, next, I told you some of the concepts are remaining, so we shall discuss them now. That is atomic number and mass number. okay, atomic number. See, atomic number, it is like the identification of that element. Prati one element ga one tandya atomic number irutti, one element ga erad atomic number irak sadhya illa. Naav hang obbare irtevi, nam gathene irbodu, adra naavu inobbare irak sadhya illa. Theita adhe riti for elements also, each element has only one atomic number. No element has two atomic numbers. So that is the identification of that element. Okay, atomic number represented by the symbol Z. Okay, what it represents? Atomic number, it represents the number of protons or electrons in a neutral atom. Atomic number represents the number of protons or electrons in a neutral atom. Like for example, I take the element carbon. What is the atomic number of carbon? 6. What does this mean? Carbon atom contains 6 protons and 6 electrons. Okay, I hope this is clear. Next, we'll take another element, sodium. Atomic number is 11. Atomic number you write on the left hand side, lower left hand side. Right, so sodium atomic number 11. What does this mean? Sodium atom contains 11 protons and 11 electrons. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. That is atomic number. It represents what? The number of protons or electrons in a neutral atom, not an anion or a cation, in a neutral atom. Okay, so next, mass number. Okay, the mass number means what? Mass number, what does it represent? It represents the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. Mass number, what does it represent? It represents the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. Like for example, I write carbon 6, 12. Okay, carbon 6, 13, carbon 6, 14. This represents what? Atomic number. Each element has only one atomic number, I have told you. Right, so this represents atomic number, this represents mass number. This is mass number. This represents atomic number. Okay, so here, mass number means what? It is the sum of protons and neutrons. It is the sum of protons and neutrons. Means, look here, how many protons and electrons are present in carbon? Carbon contains 6 protons and 6 electrons. 6 protons and 6 electrons. How many neutrons are there? How will you find? There is a formula. A is equal to Z plus N. There is a formula for finding out the number of protons, electrons and neutrons. What is it? A is equal to Z plus N. Where A is what? Mass number. A is what? Mass number. Z is what? Atomic number. N is what? Number of neutrons. N is what? Number of neutrons. Now here, how you are going to find out the number of neutrons in carbon? Carbon 6, 12. You are going to use this formula. What is the mass number? A is equal to Z plus N. What is the mass number of carbon here? 12. What is the atomic number of carbon? 6. You don't know the number of neutrons? N. So equal to 6. N is equal to 6. Same way, you can find out for carbon 6, 13. So, A is equal to Z plus N. What is the mass number? 13. Atomic number 6 plus N. So, N is equal to 7. Okay? So, A is mass number, Z is atomic number, N is number of neutrons. Atomic number, what does it represent? The number of protons and electrons in a neutral atom. Mass number, what does it represent? It represents the number of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus of an atom. Okay? Now, next we come to the concept of isotopes. Now here, what do you mean by isotopes? Just now I wrote C6-12, C6-13, C6-14. Okay, these are isotopes of carbon. I call these as isotopes of carbon. How you can define the isotopes? By looking at the example. Look at the example and tell what is same? Atomic number is same. So elements having the same atomic number, what is different? Mass number is different. So elements having same atomic number but different mass number. Elements having same atomic number but different mass number, you can call them as isotopes. Or you can say another way, they are atoms of the same element having different number of neutrons. Number of protons in all the three will be the same. Because it is carbon, number of protons will be the same. Because this represents what? Number of protons and electrons. So, the elements, atoms of the same element, which are having different number of neutrons, those also you can call as isotopes. Okay, these are three isotopes of carbon. Then you have isotopes of chlorine. Chlorine. These are isotopes of chlorine, isotopes of hydrogen. Protium, deuterium and tritium. Protium, deuterium and tritium. This is deuterium. This is tritium. Okay, so they are isotopes. Okay, and one more term, nucleons. Nucleus. Nucleus contains which particles, subatomic particles? Protons and neutrons. So nucleons means what? The particles present in the nucleus. Okay. Which particles are present in the nucleus? Nucleons means particles present in the nucleus. Which are they? Protons plus neutrons. So, the protons and neutrons present in the nucleus, we call them as nucleons. The protons and neutrons present in the nucleus together. Protons and neutrons nucleus na irtav eradu kude nam enantevi nucleons ant karitevi, right? Okay, so that's all for today. Okay, we should stop here.